Trial by fire, get out there. You're gonna make some mistakes.
When the opportunity strikes, you have to take advantage. Who's Kutztown? You know, we know who they are, they don't know who we are. But I think after that tournament was over, they knew who we were. And I think that's very prideful for especially me and you, but I think the team in general. The best thing about it is the fact that, you know, like Mike said earlier, it's a team sport. So it's not like most games where it's just one person can completely dominate the game. You have to use your other players. And a lot of the times you'll see that you use all seven of your players on the field at a time. Like you go through everything. And especially on defense too, it's important because one person makes the wrong move, especially on a man type thing, that that could be the point. So it's really the thing I love about it the most is the fact that you have to trust in each other. And it promotes really good teamwork and team strength, team bonding.
We have a no exclusion rule, and you kind of touched on that, but it's like we don't have tryouts for the team. It's whoever wants to come, it's like come play and we're going to teach you how to play and it's going to be awesome. So I think that really promotes like just a healthy, happy family is what I like to think in my head. It's like just come, just work your butt off, and that's all we ask. And then, you know, doing that, you make these connections with people that are much stronger than you really realize.
I really appreciate how we all have each other's backs. Like, it's not just like you go and like we just hug and we have like, you know, the big group celebration, everything. It's like we go after, we just have squad dinners, we eat together, we hang out on the weekends together. It's just, we always know where we're at with each other and we can always keep it real. And I really appreciate that.
The team's my support group. If I ever had a problem, anybody on the team would be willing to like stop what they were doing and hang out with me or give me a ride somewhere or just offer any advice that they could. We really are always there for each other and it means a lot.
It means a lot to me because like when I first got here, like I didn't really know anyone at the school. I just kind of like came here on a limb and I figured why not just join the team. And I really met like all my first like initial like good friends on the team, and now like even next year, I'm going to be living with, like, some of my teammates. Like, some people I would have never, like, met if I would have decided to go anywhere else. And it just really made me feel, like, it made me feel really, like, welcomed coming here. And, like, that I really had, like, friends and family around me who, like, really helped integrate me, I guess.
What I want most for the team at High Tide is for us to feel accomplished and to know that we went out there and we did our best. And there's no regrets and we just play our best. That's what I really hope. Even if we don't win, I think us just going out and playing our best is what I really hope to accomplish.
Well, this is the first time we're going to see some of the newer kids from the spring semester, so I'm kind of excited to see how we're all going to play together, especially with some of the newer players and how they experience playing with us.
Like, for the ones that I've been to, like, they're looking better than they did last year, and we were pretty damn good last year, so I think they're ready.
Well, we're trying to be competitive. We're also trying to have a good time because High Tide, as we know, is like part competitive, part having a good time because it's spring break.
Dude, High Tide!
High Tide, oh, like this, you never could expect.
High Tide!
With some laggy and kinetic.
So just relax.
It's too chill out here, man.
Lay back and be easy. Take your time, let freely and be easy. Yeah. You know, palm trees
where we sitting right. Our first game was against UConn, which is kind of scary because that's like that top tier team we were just talking about. It's like scary to go out and compete against those bigger teams, but at the same time it's like a great experience. So that first game we actually lost. We lost 12-9. So just recapping on that game, I think a couple things. That's the OD curse right there, and I think we saw in that game. Mm-hmm. And when I say the OD curse, I mean we come out so slow. And that's something we've struggled with in the past. It's just we need something to happen. We need a big play. We need someone to start the fire, and then the engine's kicking. They came out. They were up 0-4 on us. And so they scored four times before we were even really completing just passes.
Yeah.
And that's like crazy.
Yeah, well, dare I say we're a second half team?
Yeah.
I mean, how many times do we say that? I mean, it's kind of like almost our catchphrase at this point because how much we say it. Like that OD curse, we just start out so slow, and in that game we started out down 4. So, you know, that, like I was saying, is my biggest fear. So when you come out 0-4, that morality starts to hit real like rock bottom. But actually, I was really proud in that game because we had that 0-4 start, but then, you know, we finished, what was it, 9-12. So we really showed up in that second half. I think we entered half like 1-7 or something crazy like that. And so then, you know, if it's 1-7 at half and then we ended up losing 9-12, so that's what, 8-5 in the second half. So we won that second half. We came out firing. It's just, we just have trouble in that first half, man. We got to correct that.
I see a line of cars and they are painted black, with flowers and my love hope never to come back.
So third day, this is, at this point in the tournament, it's elimination. We're seeded very low. We only won one out of five games, so we're really at the bottom. So what that ended up meaning was we had to play an extra game if we were gonna go to the championship of the bracket. So we just wouldn't have that like first round bye, so to say. So our first game was early in the morning and we played Ramapo College, who's actually one of the teams that's a pretty good rival of ours, but they're also a very well-spirited team. We love playing them. But they're one of the local colleges, like they go to a lot of the same tournaments that we do. So we play them all the time, you know. We know them, they know us. So it's really like every time we get out there, it's like just compete because we know what you're going to do and they know what we're going to do. So it's really just who wants it more on that day. We took it to them and the score ended up being 12-5 in the end with us winning. But I think in that game, our confidence was through the roof. I know myself personally, I was not afraid to throw the disc in that game. I did not feel like they had nothing. And that's the thing, though, too. You come out, we had a really good, I remember specifically, a really good like pregame huddle and like talk before this game. And like everyone was hype. Everyone was ready to go. And I think that really made the difference. You know, we just came out hot. I think we came up on them 3-0. And I remember we were on the sideline. Everyone's like, are we going to 13-0 these kids? Is this going to happen right now? But, you know, obviously they're a good team. You know, they're going to come back. They're going to score some points. And, you know, that's just a given. That's how the sport's played. But I don't think there was one point in that game where it looked like they were going to win.
No, never.
And exactly, that's just how it works. You know, we get out there, we get on a run, you know, we're looking good.
My favorite thing about this team is our willingness to grow and succeed. So, you know, you take what we had day one. For all of you, think about your first day as a member of the Oregon Donors, and now think of where you are right now. And I just think that speaks more to you than it does to anybody else, that you were the one that came to practice, you're the one that put in the work, you're the one that worked hard, and I can sit here and say I'm proud of you, Mike can sit here and say he's proud of you all we want, but when it comes down to it, you should be proud of yourself, and thanks for being an organ donor.
Hey, listen up. We got this for this one last time, all right? Last time of the semester before our last tournament. So let's just get this, let's churn this butter, all right?
Whoa, too fast.
Easy.
Relax. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Donovan. Chill out. Please, come on. Buy dinner first.
One and done. All right.
We'll switch direction. Oh. Turn it up a little bit.
Reverse cap.
Talk
and I should know. I've given my everything, and it wasn't close. People mean well, but still make a mess. From now on, I'm listening and saving my breath. Oh.